The Bowie theory, also known as egoic theory, implies that language began when our ancestors started imitating the sound in the nature around them. The first speech was onomatopoeic. But wait, what does onomatopoeia mean? It means the formation of a word by imitating the sound made by or associated with the thing the noun refers to, marked by echoic words such as splash, moo, bang, and cuckoo. In the Asian time, the mammals start communicating with others through the imitations of sounds in nature. In the example, we have a caveman that hears the sound made by a duck. Then he imitates the sound quack quack to his caveman friend to tell him about the animal he saw earlier. And then the other makes the association. And that's how language began.
Now let's move on to something more contemporary. When all of us are starting to learn how to speak, we used to refer as things as it sounds to indicate them. For example, when asking for a toy, the baby will try to imitate the sound of the animal, in this case a dinosaur, and the sound will be rar rar. Also, our parents will refer to things using onomatopoeic sounds. When they try to teach us animals, they will say oink oink to explain a pig, wow wow as in the example to explain a dog, and so on.
So, how this theory will work nowadays? Taking for example a conversation between people that speak different languages. Here we have two tourists visiting a zoo. One of them wants to show the other the monkeys.
Mira los monos.
But the other one doesn't understand him. So he refers to the animal by its sounds.
Ooh, ooh, ah, ah.
And this shows how the onomatopoeic sounds help to overcome the language barrier, suggesting a common origin.
However, this theory also has its flaws. First, not many of the words that confirm the human language are onomatopoeic. For example, when going to the pool, we don't call it splash, because it's not normal to refer to it with a sound. To explain this, we have the Eureka theory, that proposes that maybe some ancestors assigned arbitrary sounds to signify certain things, and language was consciously invented. Secondly, the theory doesn't give an explanation to why the sounds vary from one language to another, as we can see in the example of the representation of the sound that a cat makes. In Korean, it's yang. In Japanese, it's nyan. And in English, it's meow.
Finally, another flaw that this theory has is its inability to describe abstract concepts and words such as love, peace, or death. Right. The theory of divine creation can answer this flaw. This theory proposed that God gave us this concept. And language.